on, guys? I'm Nigel with Elite Force here at SHOT Show 2018. Really excited to talk about stuff we've been talking about already, stuff you guys are already excited about, talking about the Glocks. You know that we are already coming out with the gas blowback line of the Glocks, OEM VFC. These are the ones that we started talking about at AirsoftCon, and these are going to be the first ones out of the gate. These are approved, ready to rock. It's just a matter of getting them to us at this point. So they are on their way. I'm going to say end of probably second quarter. So the next couple months, 2 to 3 months, we should start seeing these come in. So you guys already know about that. We've talked about that. We're starting to look at some other, even more premium offerings. And now we're looking at Glocks CO2 powered. These are going to be the CNC slide. It's going to have the steel slide catch, reinforced steel spring guide, and some steel reinforcement parts on the hammer assembly in there. This is going to come with the Glock hard case, just like the real firearm. And again, this is going to be CO2 powered. So I keep on trying to remind everybody and remind myself that what you're seeing right now just happens to be the stuff that got through our quality control program, that Glock was okay with, that Umarex USA felt okay with, and that we got approved on. But this is just the tip of the iceberg. There's so many more models coming out, so many more OEMs. So for you guys that want the subcompacts, for you guys that want the full auto 18Cs, it's all coming. So just hang in there. It's coming, trust me. And in the same breath, let's talk about this. So this is going to be a metal slide, right? Polymer lower, but it's going to be a fixed slide, non-blowback, CO2 powered. It's going to have the stick mag on it, right? But for all intents and purposes, feels like a Glock, looks like a Glock, shoots BBs. So we're going to have something for everybody, no matter where your price point's at, no matter how much money you can spend, we are going to have a Glock option for you, for sure. So a little bit of something for everybody. Let's keep moving around. Talking about the Avalon series. So you guys already know about the Avalon series. It's been a great year for it. We got the new 416 mixed in, but some changes to the Avalon. You're going to see now it's going to have the Avalon markings on the receiver, so it's going to be even easier to know that you're dealing with an Avalon here. It's going to have the CNC'd ambidextrous mag release now, which is a great feature addition to the 2018 Avalon. Internally, it's going to be the same. It's going to have the ECS gearbox, but now they've updated the MOSFET inside, so they made it a little bit more robust, beefed up some of the resistors. You know, there's some issues with the higher dump batteries. When you get to like a 20C or a 25C dump LiPo, it was causing some hiccups with the MOSFET, so they beefed that up a little bit. And then in addition to the Avalon series, we're going to have the Avalon Gladius right here. PDW style, key mods on the side, pick rail monolithic on top, pick rail on the bottom, one piece upper receiver, PDW action. We went with the crane stock just to kind of differentiate it from the QRS stocks on the rest of the line. The weight reduction on this is awesome. So if you want a lighter weight gun for CQB or something like that, or just a lighter weight gun in general, this Gladius is for you. Internally, it's going to have the ECS gearbox. So the silky smooth reliability, durability, performance that you get out of the regular Avalons, you're going to get that in the Gladius as well. Let's talk about it up here, man. I'm going to get this one down off the wall because it's so beautiful. And truth be told, I probably started working at Elite Force just because of my love for the 416. Big fan of this thing. So this is going to be the A5, keeping in theme of keeping it updated with the real HK 416 firearm. This is going to be the A5, the newest updates. As you can see, it's going to have the angled magwell on there, so now you're going to be able to put in your P-mags. It's going to have the updated rail with the integrated flip-up front sight there. And then the gun's going to be super ambidextrous, so your selector's going to be ambi. Your mag catch is going to be ambidextrous, and then your bolt catch is even ambidextrous. So you got your big paddle on this side with the receiver guard on there, but now you've got the bolt release on both sides. How nice is that? The new slim profile club stock, which is really nice. Not as clunky as the old HK 416 club stock. And then to top it all off, man, internally, it's going to have that ECS gearbox from the Avalon series like its brother. So I'm really excited about that. I think that's going to be a late second quarter, early third quarter type thing. So around late summer, fall. So yeah, there you go. A lot of awesome stuff coming out from Elite Force Umarex USA this year. That's about it, man.